afternoon, and thank you for joining us for today's webinar, HVAC Digital Marketing Made Easy Using the Surefire Cloud. My name is Michelle Lutman, and I am the content and media producer here at Surefire Local. I am joined by our Chief Marketing Officer, Shashi Balamkonda, and our webinar ninja, Steve Eastlack, who is ready and excited to help answer your questions. Speaking of those questions, you can communicate with us using the question box, which is on the right-hand side of your screen. Why don't you go ahead and see if you can locate that right now and let us know where you're joining us from today. We'll be sending messages and discussion questions to the group throughout the webinar, so be sure to check that out. Before we get into your digital marketing, I wanted to tell you a little bit about how Surefire Local started and the story behind how the Surefire Local Marketing Cloud is the marketing solution that works as hard as you do. It all started with a business owner who taught his son the value of hard work. The son, our founder and CEO, Chris, went on to lead several venture-backed Web 2.0 startups. He never forgot the memories of watching his dad get up early in the morning to track down new business. He wondered if there was a way for 21st century technology to multiply the efforts of small local companies like his father's. Turns out there was. Surefire Local started with an idea, a way to help small businesses rank higher in search engines. Today, it's an unbeatable marketing engine backed up by expert consultants with one mission, help local businesses generate new business by getting discovered online. The Surefire Local Marketing Cloud allows you to do three things: see more, do more, and get more help. Over the years, we've had the privilege of working alongside hundreds of local companies and watching many of them double and triple their leads with Surefire Local. Some call it a digital marketing transformation, but we just call it hardworking marketing for hardworking people. Today, one lucky attendee is going to take home a Google Home Mini Smart Speaker. We will be announcing the winner at the end. If you don't win one, though, you don't have to go home empty-handed. Everyone here today is eligible to get a Google Chromecast, but I will get more of that later. Today, we are joined by our very own SVP of Client Services, Bob Sheehan. Bob has great knowledge in the HVAC industry and has a fantastic presentation for you all. So for now, I'm going to pass it on over to Bob. Bob, take it away.
Thank you, Michelle, and welcome everybody to the webinar. Thank you for joining us this afternoon. I'm going to talk for probably half an hour, 45 minutes. Feel free, if anybody's got any questions or anything they wanted to say, just pop something into the chat window, and we will try to address them either, you know, in the flow of the conversation or at the end, you know, depending on what's going on. The idea here is to talk about how, you know, how to handle digital marketing, really, how to use a platform that we've developed called the Surefire Marketing Cloud to kind of manage all of the things that need to be managed. And you know, I've been doing this now at Surefire for about 9 years. I go back to the very beginning of this, and probably the biggest thing that's been going on is this idea of change. That digital marketing constantly changes. You know, Google updates their algorithm, you know, dozens of times a year, a couple of major ones every year that really require us to do something different. And the whole landscape changes, the whole idea of really how to do this and what things are important changes. So, you know, we've gotten to this place now that's very different from where it was even a couple of years ago, this idea of a multi-touch customer journey. You know, it used to be that if you had a website and you were, you were reasonably good at putting some content on your site, it would show up in search and people would click on it and fill out a form or make a phone call. Next thing you knew, you had a lead and some business and it was easy. And you really didn't have to worry about a whole lot beyond that. Like I remember the time when that was the case, when, you know, this idea of all of these other things that you need to do really didn't happen, right? And now we've got a situation where, you know, Google will tell us, they use this number in their presentations, but on average, a customer sees your brand or your advertising or your messaging somewhere on the internet 12 and a half times on average before they end up coming to you as a lead. And of those 12 and a half times, most of them are not your website. So the, you know, things may start with a website, but they certainly don't end there. There's lots of opportunities for people to either find you or, in many ways, find your competitor. So we talk about tactics like, you know, news articles and display ads and email campaigns and remarketing on AdWords campaigns and, you know, just general kind of, how do I get my website visible in search? And that's the way it is now, where you've got to do lots of different things. The way it was even a few years ago is very different. If you look at, you know, the late 90s and really into the halfway through the the last decade, it was all about keywords, right? You built a website, you stood it up, you put keywords on a page, and if those keywords match the search, then Google will put that page very high in search, and you'd succeed. Somewhere around the 2007 kind of area, just before the Great Recession, there was a lot of proliferation of these web services. This idea that you could take content and post it out on the internet in all kinds of different ways, and have all of that posting and that accumulated digital presence add up to success for you. That those things would generate traffic to your site. That people would see you in all those places and kind of not remember you, but certainly be imprinted with your brand and kind of know who you were, and that would be the way that you got traffic to the site. And it's now evolved into a place where it's much more complex than that, and they've added the idea of local, right? The geolocation piece of this is very much a factor in what goes on today. So we talk about four things, and you can see them in the lower right-hand corner of the page here, and we'll talk about them a number of different times during the presentation, but really what's important is recency. How often do you do things? How often do you publish content? How often do you change the keywords on your site? How often do you touch your directory listings, right? Recency. Relevancy. How relevant are the things that you publish on the internet to your business? Do they match the queries of the customers you're trying to reach? And if they don't, you're going to have a hard time succeeding on the internet. The big one that we think about a lot, and we've actually changed the name of the company to reflect this, is proximity. There is now, with the advent of the smartphone, and everybody's got a thing in their hand 24/7 that tells the search engines where they are, this idea of proximity. That what Google wants to do is, when a customer searches for something, Google wants to deliver not only the best possible result for that search, but they want to deliver the closest one. They want to deliver the one that is reasonably in the right area for them, and matches all the other things that makes them a valuable search. And of course, prominence, right? The idea that if I see you in a lot of different places, if you're able to scale these activities, right, all of this publishing that we do and these postings, and if you're able to get that to a place where you're very prominent on the internet in combination with everything else that's going on, that's how you succeed. And that's, that's different. That's relatively new, the combination of all four of those things. We focus a lot on all of them, and we think we're particularly good at the proximity piece of this thing. And for that reason, most of our clients, and we know most of your clients, are local businesses that focus on, a handful of zip codes, and that's where they get the majority of their traffic. So we care much more about, whether you succeed in the three towns that touch your home base than we do in, whether you're in some other state or, somewhere halfway across the country. So along with this whole idea of prominence and the change in the website and the internet, is this idea of lots of different things that need to get done. And this company was originally founded, the way we began, was the idea that a local business could scale these things, that you could publish a lot of content efficiently, and that you could work on social media and cover a lot of different bases and handle your directories. And then if a local business could manage this stuff all in one place and kind of scale those activities, that you'd be able to succeed in ways that national businesses like Home Depot or any of these other, people who Lowe's or, the people who really scale the internet and really look big on the internet, that you could actually outperform them locally if you were able to do these things at scale. And that was the premise of the company back in 2009, and it's still the foundation of the company today. That what we try to do is to make sure all of these things happen in the right way, make sure that things that don't matter aren't really where we focus, that we focus on the things that actually move the needle, and that we provide a platform where a local business or an individual doing marketing for a local business can actually scale the activities and can manage the whole thing. That's been the hard part, really. We're going to talk a few minutes here about, you know, the elements of what a kind of a digital program looks like, how it gets built, and what it costs, and you know, typical kind of approach here. We build websites on websites is always kind of where it starts, right? You have to have some kind of a home-based presence on the internet. And so we build websites for our customers. We've been doing it since the very beginning. And we build it on WordPress. And the reason we do that is because WordPress is the biggest platform out there. It's open source, and it has the capability of being updated by the user community. So there's lots of developers out there. And when something gets developed for WordPress, it's very easy to upgrade that platform and take advantage of that technological improvement where other platforms aren't necessarily the same way. So we build on WordPress because we know that when we build it today, it's going to be good in 5 years or 10 years or down the road. And it also, we know that there's things in WordPress that are very SEO friendly. We build on mobile platforms so that the sites look good on your mobile phone as well as on your desktop, that there's SEO components in here. There's plugins and ways to manage SEO inside the platform that will, you know, help you to succeed with the website. It's not just some place to put a couple of pages of content. It's reaching out and helping Google to find itself, right? And that it's easy to work with, so you will update it, because what we want to do is to encourage clients, and we certainly do it ourselves, to update content frequently, and so you need an easy way to do that. Typically, a website, if you look across the small business community, a website costs about $4,000, right? That's pretty normal, out there for a small business website. Another big component of what goes on out there, the kind of the foundation of a digital marketing program, is AdWords. And AdWords is a way to obviously get more leads, right? So we build these programs around landing pages. We track the calls. We want to make sure that these programs are manageable. We go back to the very beginning, and we want to try to kind of understand all these things and how they're working and make adjustments to them as you go along, so that they will actually, you know, get better as time goes on. So, you know, we manage these AdWords programs either, you know, we manage them for clients, or when you see the platform that I'm going to show you later on, there is the capability inside that platform of managing your own AdWords program. So, you know, clients can do this. We can do it. You know, we built the platform in ways that, you know, a marketing person could come on here and run a program for somebody independently of us. But that capability is all built into the program. Typically, you know, small businesses are spending $1,000, $1,500 a month on AdWords, and, you know, they're getting a return on that. And the return, the cost per lead, if you will, kind of thing, that varies by industry. In some industries, they are willing to tolerate a much higher cost per lead than others. But the whole idea behind AdWords is to decide what that cost per lead should be and then have the tools to be able to work towards that. So another component, a lot of people ask us, we hear about this all the time, we actually participate in some of it, is this idea of email, right? And it allows you to send things to your customers, send things to people who aren't your customers, as long as they're in your database. We promotional messages get done in email. It's very inexpensive. It's an inexpensive and responsive way to, you know, get additional business from people who are in your funnel somewhere. And so we have many email programs running with clients that we handle now. And we encourage this as a method of communication, as a way, a component of a healthy digital marketing program. Every one of our sites, and I think if you looked out on the business, you know, internet, you'd find that most sites have a blog. And the whole purpose behind a blog goes back to the relevance and recency components that we talked about earlier when we looked at, you know, the components of a successful marketing program, right? We want to write relevant content that is targeted to the people who we want to be customers, right? And then we want to publish that content frequently and with, you know, a proximity component to it, so that we we make that content about the place where we exist, right? The place where we want to do business. So we write about 1,200 blogs a month for our customers. We encourage customers to do it themselves. We provide that capability inside the platform so that anybody who might want to, you know, write a blog a month or a blog a week, or, you know, talk about what's going on in their business or in their lives, or maybe the charity that they're working on in the business, that capability exists, and it's very simple with the use of WordPress and the SurePulse platform that we have. That allows you to, you know, kind of scale that activity. So, you know, between the content and the, you know, the cost of writing it and getting images for it, you know, people spend about $400 a month doing that. But that's an important component and a pretty efficient way to get the right kind of content out there. If you've been reading a lot of the blogs that are out there in the kind of the industry press, you'd be hearing a lot about reviews. Most of the small businesses that I talk to, I talk to 20 or 30 a week, they think about reviews all the time. They understand how important it is, and they understand that Google cares about it a great deal. And so when you do the reviews piece correctly, when you maintain a good reputation, and when you respond to your customers, and when you get a lot of your customers to kind of say that they had a good experience with you, Google takes that to mean you're a reliable partner and somebody that can that they can direct people to, that they will put you higher on the page if you have a good review scenario. If your star rating is high, every increase in stars is worth 5 to 9% in sales. And there's a lot of people, and there's been a lot of research done on this, who will not purchase anything from somebody when there's negative reviews out there. They focus on the idea that they want to be happy, and if your customers currently are happy, then that's likely to continue. But if they're not, they won't take the chance. So we focus on many things with reviews, but the kind of the big ideas are, you know, make sure your business is designed to, you know, satisfy your customers, and then ask them at the end how they did, and get them to be your, you know, promoter, and when you get that to happen, that's a very important thing. It helps your digital presence, it helps customers come to you, and it certainly does a lot of good for your business. Directory listings is another core component of this. They've been around for a long time. There are thousands of directory listings. There are only about 50 that matter with Google, so we try to focus on the right group of directory listings. We have a package of 74 directories that we care about, and we make sure that people's name, address, and phone number, companies, right, that's consistent across everything. So that's called your NAP record, your name, address, and phone number record, and we achieve that across 74 directories, of which 50 are the most important that Google cares about, and we keep that up to date. And that's a very important ranking component for a website. And you can see here there's been some research done on how difficult it is to keep up with this, but on average, a company's core business information will change 61 times a year. Now, that's not always somebody changing their address or changing the name of the company. Many times it's changing, you know, some aspect of maybe a photo gallery, or a new review was put on it, or, you know, some database changed some component as part of its algorithm. That happens automatically. So managing this ecosystem of directory listings is very, very important, and we provide that capability right in the cloud for that reason. It's one of the most important things that you can do. Social media, everybody thinks about social media. I hear this a lot. I get customers, you know, they say, well, you know, do you guys publish to my Facebook, and do you handle Twitter and all of that? And certainly the answer is yes. We think it's a very important signal to send to Google, to tell them that you're active on the internet, and that you care about, you know, your public face, what you look like to the world. It's a great way to do things like events, you know, seminars. We have a lot of customers who have, you know, seminars in their buildings, right? You know, here's what you need to know about heating systems, or here's what you need to know about roofing, or, you know, there's a lot of different ways that you can do that. But social media, social advertising is a great way to get that stuff out, and so we have that capability within the program. On average, that's a few hundred dollars. It's not typically a very high spend, and we find that it's a very efficient spend, that it's the kind of thing that gets you a good cost per lead, and you get a lot of reach and a lot of engagement from customers on social without spending a ton of money at all. When you add all that up, I mean, you can see it gets you to some pretty big numbers, right? You could spend easily $7,200 a month on all of this, and we've got, you know, history with a lot of people that, you know, they are spending that kind of money. And what happens when you gang this up and kind of make this more efficient into a platform is you're able to take a lot of that cost out of it, and you're able to rescale the integrations to all of these things, and that helps our clients to scale the activities on them. In addition, you know, we typically see customers spending this kind of, you know, these kinds of dollars on shows and you know, outbound phone calls, all these components of offline stuff that happens. And some of these things, you know, we end up tracking inside the website, where we're able to, on the platform, you know, show some of the impact of some of the offline things that you do as well. But, you know, primarily the platform is about what you're doing online. So when we first got going, this chart was a lot smaller, but today there are something like 5,000 options for how you can use technology on the internet. This chart has been around since probably the year 2000, and, you know, they've been tracking all of these companies. We're actually here just to the right of the 5100 box. We're in there as one of the options, and it grows every year. We expect this thing to be double the size it is in a couple of years. And it just makes things much more difficult for a local business to try to, you know, cover all of these things and to try to do the right thing, right? How do I look at a 5,100 item, you know, list of options here and decide what I should be doing? I mean, I can't imagine if I was a small business trying to figure that out. So what we do is we kind of, you know, we understand this stuff and we stay close to the industry. And we make sure that the things that are on the platform, the things that we provide, the tools that we provide to the customer, are the right ones, right? And we test it all the time. We built the platform in an open source way so that we can add new things as needed, and we can take things out as they're not needed anymore and make adjustments to it so that it's always something that's useful to the end user. And something that, you know, if you're bringing it to your customers, you know that it will be kind of focused in the right place to make sure that it works. So again, it's all about recency, proximity, relevance, and prominence. And we think about all of those things in everything that we do. We don't put anything on the platform that doesn't satisfy one of these criteria. We think about this a lot when we're building things like SEO programs. And, you know, we want to satisfy these signals to Google and make sure that they're being done correctly so that we can get people to have success. So when you do all these things, there are a number of different places in the search engine that are impacted by that. So if you look on the left here, you'll see it's a pretty typical search engine results page. We just did a search, plumbers near me. And the search engine results page is organized in a way that the things that you do, that recency, relevance, proximity, and all of that, is impacted individually by those things. So when you do AdWords, for instance, which is really about, you know, proximity and relevance and, you know, sending out an offer in exactly the place where you want customers, when you do AdWords, those ads show up at the top of the page all the time. And you manage that as its own thing. It doesn't come from anywhere else. There's nothing else that impacts it. You can control that, and you can literally be number one on that page if you want to, by managing that program that way. If you want to be in the maps, that middle section there, we call that local SEO. That's managed a different way. There's a directory listing piece of the cloud that helps you to kind of figure out how to get to that place, right? And there's a group of activities, there's a certain group of things that we do that helps us succeed in that way, and lands you on that map listing there, and in a way that will obviously get customers to come to you. And then organic SEO at the bottom is all about the content that we put on the site, the links that we have going to it, the kind of the management of that whole ecosystem, right? And when you manage that correctly, you end up potentially in all three of these places. We like to think of it as shots on goal, so that you've got, you're not done just because, okay, I'm number one in AdWords and therefore I'm number one. Well, I like to be number one in maps, and I like to be number one in organic. I like to be number one three times on that page, and that gets me three extra shots on goal with that customer, three extra opportunities for a customer to click on my ad, and it's two other places where a competitor won't be. So I like that in a lot of different ways. And the other thing that we find is that customers, some customers will click on an ad, some customers won't. And they know that the ads are at the top, and they go look for the organic listings, or they go look for the local listings before they click. And so we find that when you succeed in more than one of these places, one plus one can equal three, because you get these people that are focused in certain areas, and you can literally mine the different sections of the search engine results page for results in different ways. So, what we're trying to do is to use all of these different components and manage them all in one place with, you've got analytics that you got to look at, and you've got leads that you have to think about, and how do I worry about social, right? What are my social results looking like, and how do I manage reputation and directories? And what happened with us, when we go back to the very beginning of the business, and we had, first we had one client, then we had five clients, then we had 20 clients, and it became, now I've got to figure out how to do all of these things for 20 clients. And then we had 40 clients, and it was like, now we really got a problem. Because, we've got to sign into all of these things. We've got 38 different data sources that are coming into the cloud. We've got to sign into all of them. We've got to change the date ranges on all of them and kind of look at all this data. All of these platforms open up all at once, and it became very difficult. So the origin of what we do and how we do it comes from the need to manage all of these things and put them all in one place so that you could actually look at them in the same context. Right, and we can now see, for instance, that things that you do in the directories impact your lead flow in a certain date range, or maybe the social media activities when they're not there compared to other clients when they are there, they have different impacts on analytics, and we're able to look at all those relationships in a way that will help to grow this platform and grow the results that clients get from it. And we're actively working that kind of data problem to bring more insights into the connections between all of these things.
So thank you so much, Bob. While Bob takes a quick water break, I just want to say that we're very glad to have you all as partners, and to let us know if you need anything by emailing us at marketing@surefirelocal.com, or if you'd even like to reach out to Mitch Schwartz, he'd be more than happy to have a conversation with you. We were going to do a poll, but we're going to save that for the end. So Bob, get back.
Okay. So the concept here is that when you put all this stuff together into one platform, and you really focus on the results that come from the different things, then you can use that platform to get to ROI. And that's what everybody wants, right? Everybody wants to spend $100 and get back $1,000 or whatever that metric is for your business. And so we have to understand what's working and what isn't, and how to measure all of this stuff. So we bring all this data in so we can get metrics on performance and attribute leads to a source. We want to look at things separately and then combine them. So attributing leads to a source is generally fairly difficult, but when we bring it all together like the way we do, and I'll show you that in a second, it becomes very easy to understand the parts of your program that are working better than the other parts, and then how they add up to the result that you're going to get at the end. And then you have the option and really the power to go in there and move that needle around and add to things that work better and delete from things that don't work better to get to the ROI number that you need at the bottom line. We want the ability to quickly launch campaigns. One of the things that happened to us early on in the business is we would have customers say, you know, I want to get into an AdWords campaign. I want to start an AdWords campaign. And it was like, uh-oh, what now, right? And it could take, you know, from scratch, it could take 3 weeks to stand one of those up with a landing page and, you know, sourcing mobile phone numbers and tracking phone numbers and doing design and you know, standing up entire programs, right? We've now built that stand up, that whole process, and automated that and stood it up inside the cloud to a place where we can do that same day. Like, we can literally have a meeting in the afternoon and the client can be getting leads on that pay-per-click campaign that same day. So that's been a very big deal for us and our clients because, you know, you can, you know, don't have to stand there and wait. You know, if I decide I want to be doing something today, I want to do it today. So we've built that capability in here where we can do that. There's an integration into QuickBooks here that we think is really important. A lot of small businesses, many of the small businesses that we work with, they run their business on QuickBooks. And when customers have QuickBooks online, we can actually plug into that and have the leads that come out of the website and go through the cloud end up going to QuickBooks, and then we track the dollars that get sold on those leads. And we're now able to come back and say, okay, here's what was spent by, you know, the different kinds of media, and compare that to the dollars that were derived from it, and understand exactly what ROI is for all the different components of somebody's program. So that capability is definitely part of it. So the idea is visually to make this thing easy, but to bring in a lot of useful information, right? So you can see when we look at the dashboard, we built this for a business owner. We said, all right, you know, if I own a business and I get up in the morning, I want to understand how my leads are. I want to know what kind of traffic is coming to my site. I want to kind of see the big picture, right? And I'm not going to necessarily get into the nitty-gritty, but I want a dashboard that'll give me, you know, the top line stuff. So we built that. And we can now look at, you know, obviously first is goal completions. In our world, goal completions is form submissions and phone calls. And then we layer that on with all the traffic statistics. And you can look at a 3 month or a 6 month or a 1 year time period and understand how you're doing in relation to the prior period as well. So you can see whether you're up, down, or sideways. And, you know, if I'm a business owner, I look at something like this and I see, you know, increases, I know I'm okay and I can kind of move on and, you know, have my day and not worry too much about it. So we did that to kind of make it easy to kind of see where you're at. The three things we talk about a lot, and Michelle alluded to them earlier, is this idea of see more, do more, get more help. Right. So the first thing that we did when we built this was we built it so we could see the data. Right. We couldn't get to the data because there were too many places to sign in, and we needed to kind of see all the data in one place and organize it in a way that we could work on it. And that was the first thing we did. And then it became evident that the thing that really would make something like this powerful is if I could do something in it. I wanted to be able to publish. I wanted to be able to change my directory listings. I wanted to be able to stand up an AdWords program, right? And all that do more made the thing really useful to us. And then ultimately, when we moved that and kind of gave it to the clients, they were able to do more, and that's what that really helped. That made it made it different, right? And then we've got help, the item number three here. We've got help at all different levels. So we've got some programs that folks buy from us where they don't get any help at all. We don't have any coaches or client, you know, account managers at all. And then others where, you know, you can get quite a bit of help. And it's all up to you, really, the customer, how much help you want. And some people start with a lot of help, and then after a while they move to less help. And that's all flexible and something that we do inside the program, to where, you know, it fits everybody's needs. So, you know, we bring in some unique kinds of data here, right? This is a particular thing called, we call it a word cloud, where we're able to look at the words that somebody is searching for that brought them to your website. So you can see they all have kind of a theme to them. They're all along the same you know, industry, which is good because obviously we're trying to bring certain kinds of traffic to a site. And you can see there's different, some of these words are bigger than others, and that's related to the amount of searching that gets done. So a bigger word would be one that gets searched more and brings more people to the site, therefore it's more important. And so we can look at a word cloud like this and understand what the big, you know, what the big idea is, what's being more successful on our site. And if we don't like that, if we look at that and say, oh, that's not really right, I've got, you know, I really care about this other business over here, we have the opportunity to use that data and, you know, write different content or change the focus of the blogs or change the focus of the AdWords program, for instance, or, you know, there's plenty of things, the actions that can be taken from something like that. But it all starts with see more, right? I got to be able to see what's going on. Ratings and reviews. When we go to the ratings and reviews page, you can see we're out there scraping the internet and finding how people are talking about you. When you look here, right, this word cloud down the bottom is based on the reviews, right? And then here are the reviews, and the star ratings are here. And in some cases, when you look at this page, you'll see a reply button right underneath the stars. And the reason for that is if the customer hasn't replied to it yet, it gives you that capability right on the platform. So now, you know, we encourage our customers, and I think it's really good advice that no matter what the star rating, 100% of your review should be replied to. You should be responding, even if it's to say, thank you very much, we appreciate the business that we did with you. That's all you have to say, but you should reply to every single one of them. And we give you that capability inside the tool in a very easy way, so you can put a review or a response on Google or on Yelp or on, you know, Facebook or whatever, and it's very simple and fast to do. Directory listings, as I said before, we take the NAP data and make sure that it's consistent across 74 directories. These are the logos of those directories, and then we look up the top there and we score that. We make sure that the listing score reflects an accurate you know, propagation of that information across the whole system. So sometimes we have customers that they don't do certain things, so we don't get 100%. But for the most part, out of that 74, we're getting, you know, in the low 70s of exactly what should be on those listings being in the right place, and that's a very big deal for trying to rank a website. Publishing content. It's another piece of do more that we really think is important. I can remember when I was doing this early on, and I would have 20 or 25 clients, having to sign in and out of all those websites was very difficult. It was a pain in the neck, and you'd forget your password, and you'd have to change your password, and you had to go write it down somewhere. All of this is connected inside the cloud, so you've got one sign-on, one consistent password that gets you into all of this. And you can publish to directories, you can publish to social media, or you can publish to the website right from the same screen, and in an easy way that doesn't, you know, doesn't kind of cause you to go out of your mind trying to find your passwords. We have a mobile app. The mobile app is about leads. So when leads come in, you can see here in the middle, you've got the different leads that come in, and you can press a single button and call them back right away, or text them back right away, or send them an email. We think that's very important. The data that we have about response to leads indicates that 5 minutes is a long time. That if somebody sends you a lead and you don't call them in 10 minutes, they forget who you are. They're not even thinking about you anymore. So we try to provide the mechanism, and that's what this mobile app is all about, to really respond to leads immediately. And we find that when people do that, their conversion rates go up dramatically, that it's a very big difference. So we've got that kind of record here of the leads as they came in, the easy way to respond to them. And then if you look over on the right, we run drip campaigns against these leads where, you know, we can run, send them emails over a period of time, you know, maybe a sequence of emails that continue to try to convert that lead. And we're able to kind of understand what this customer has seen, and whether they've been set or not, whether they've become an appointment by this acquired tab, all on that same screen with that lead. So that the mobile app has really made it not only convenient for those customers to call those people back and to respond to them, but to do it in an instantaneous way that really helps the conversion rates. The same lead manager is on the computer as well, on the desktop version. It's not as pretty as the mobile app, but it definitely has all the information that we just talked about here. And all the leads will stay there, right? So they just keep coming in, and over time, this builds up into a pretty good-sized database, which then, you know, we can turn around and send emails to, or, you know, we can kind of keep an eye on them and go back. I know a lot of the folks in our businesses will take old leads, for instance, and call them back after 6 months. Well, that record is all in here, so you never have to wonder, you know, how do I find the leads from 6 months ago? They're right there. You'll never have to worry about where they are. So this is what we call the connections tab, and this really indicates all the different data sources that are coming in. There are a number that we don't put on the connections tab because they're automatic. We don't need credentials from clients in order to connect them. But these are the ones where clients come in and they'll put in their AdWords credentials or their, you know, connecting Facebook and Twitter is done through here, or Google My Business or the website, and all of that kind of, you know, makes it very easy to make all these connections so that you can then see more on the front end of the dashboard. So this give you an idea. If you look at all the social media here, you know, we've seen certainly Facebook, Twitter, and Google are the big ones, but we've seen a big increase in Pinterest. Anybody in the home services business gets a lot of additional notice on Pinterest. YouTube is certainly important. Instagram, it's all here. So we have those integrations, and as there are more, some of you may know that House is becoming more important now. Well, House doesn't have an API to allow us to connect to it, but as soon as they do, House will be on this list, and then we'll be able to post there and you know, see reviews from there and all that. We are building now what we call a marketplace, where, you know, we'll have the ability for a customer to go in and, for instance, add pay-per-click programs or advanced social media. Say somebody wants to have a social media campaign on their business that just focuses on them and focuses on posting at a very high kind of frequency, that can be done through there. We've got, you know, partners that we bring in to do things like chat. We've got a partner now that we're working with called Apex Chat, where they have a platform that actually has artificial intelligence and kind of talks to customers and gives them information without a lot of human interaction. That chat can be purchased right through the marketplace. And then we have coaches and account managers who work with people who can help them to decide, you know, which of these things they should be doing, and which ones have the best record of success. So again, it's all about dominating local search results. It's about doing the right combination of things and scaling that activity in a way that makes it, that kind of multiplies the effort and makes it work better for you over time. And so we, you know, we put it onto a platform where we call it see more, do more, get more help, right? And so we've seen this before, but this is all the elements of the digital footprint, and this is the piece that we manage. And we take that big chart of, you know, 5,100 things that nobody knows anything about, and we boil that down into something like 38 different data sources and capabilities to do the things that matter the most and the things that get you the right ROI in the end, and then put that all in a place on a platform that will show you what that ROI really is. So with that, I will turn this over to Michelle again.
Thanks, Bob. All right, so I want to mention that we are scheduling consultations with Mitch Schwartz on either Tuesday, December 5th or Thursday, December 7th. If either of those times don't work for you, you can say, please email me to schedule a call, and we will follow up with you to pick a day that works best for you to have your demo of the Surefire Local Marketing Cloud. So take a second here to select your answer. Also, Steve shared a few tools in the chat box. So if you'd like to receive those, you can email us at marketing@surefirelocal.com, or I think a lot of you already have Mitch's cell number, so don't hesitate to reach out to him and have him help you out with these tools. All righty, so now we're going to go on to the exciting Google Home Mini Speaker winner. So today's lucky recipient of the Google Home Mini is Julia Brady. Congrats, Julia. please email marketing@surefirelocal.com with your full mailing address, and we will ship that right out to you. And huge thanks again for Bob joining us today, and thank you to all of our attendees. Please be sure to join us for more upcoming webinars. We actually have one this Thursday with Apex Chat at 4 p.m. Eastern. For details on that, you can go to our website at surefirelocal.com. We have a link at the top of our homepage. And if you have any questions, feel free to email us at marketing@surefirelocal.com. Please take a minute to fill out the survey at the end and let us know how we did today and what topics you would like to hear about in the future. Thanks again, and have a great evening.
Thanks, everybody. Have a great day.